So what we'll do next is take our report and cascade it. Let's modify it so that we can see multiple products in the same workbook, and let's also modify it so that we can see multiple measures. When we're done making the changes, our cascaded report will display multiple tabs down here at the bottom. In order to get our cascade working, we'll first need to make some changes to the view definition using the view's metadata editor. In the My Report Settings property grid, find the Cascade Properties category. We've filtered our properties down using the Common button. Select the Cascade Do Cascade property and choose True from the dropdown. This property tells Dodeca whether or not to cascade the view when it's built. Next, we'll choose our Cascade Sources with the Cascade Sources property. These sources are the selectors on which I want the cascade to be built. Press the button on the right to display the Cascade Sources dialog. We decided that we'd like to cascade on product and measures, so choose the product selector from the list and click the arrow button to add it to the view. Then do the same for the measures selector and press OK. Finally, we'll need to scroll down to the selector's properties category and update the selector configuration property. Click on the selector configuration property and then press the button on the right to display the configure selectors dialog. In order to create a cascade on products and measures, we'll need to be able to make multiple selections from those dimensions. To do so, we'll simply change the selection policy for the product and measure selectors from single item to multiple items, and then press OK. Go ahead and preview the changes to the view by pressing the preview button. Now when I open the product selector, I'm presented with checkboxes so that I can choose multiple items from any place in the hierarchy. I'll make a few selections for measures as well. Notice that when we view the scenario selector, because we didn't change its configuration to allow multiple selections, it still allows only a single selection to be made. Press the Build View button to build the view, and you'll see that there are now multiple tabs at the bottom, each one representing a sheet in the cascade. We can pop open the same report in Excel, and you'll notice that all of our cascaded sheets are preserved. All we need to do now is commit the changes. Go ahead and press the commit button, and then press yes to confirm that you wish to commit the changes and save the view to the database. Now the runtime deployment of my report has cascade functionality. Before we finish, let's say that we wanted to make a change to the Excel template. For example, let's say that we want to change the color of our row and column headers. Go ahead and return to Excel. We'll change these to green. And we'll change these to green as well. So now that we've made some modifications to the template, let's go ahead and save the changes. Now all we have to do is return to Dodeca and re-import the template as a binary artifact. right-click on the view in the Runtime View Selector, and then select Edit Excel Template, My Report Version 1 from the context menu that appears. Ultimately, we could have navigated to Admin Binary Artifacts from the Dodeca menu and then selected My Report from the list in the center pane. Anyway, go ahead and click Import. Dodeca remembers the Excel template previously imported and automatically selects it. So now we can just press Open. You'll notice that there's a new modified date and checksum under the imported file properties for the binary artifact. Press Commit and then Yes to confirm that you wish to save the changes to the database. Now when we run the view, we'll see our updated color scheme. Additionally, Dodeca does allow you to save multiple versions of the same Excel template to the database. This allows you, for instance, to revert back to a previous or alternate version of an Excel template at any time. If you wish to create a new version of an Excel template, instead of just overwriting the current one, select the binary artifact in question, which in our case is My Report, and then press New Version. You'll notice that upon pressing New Version, a new copy of the binary artifact appears in the center pane. This copy is identical to the original My Report, but with an updated version number. All we have to do now is import an updated version of the Excel template. So let's return for a second to our template in Excel. I'll go ahead and change the color of the text again, this time making it gray. Again, I'll save the changes to the template and then return to Dodeca. Now we simply have to import the Excel template into the new version, which is version 2. With the new version of My Report selected in the center pane, press the Import button. Again, Dodeca remembers the Excel template associated with this binary artifact, so we can just press Open. Go ahead and press the Commit button, and then press Yes to confirm that you wish to commit the changes and save the new version of the My Report binary artifact to the Dodeca database. Now, return to the view definition for My Report and find the Excel template properties category. For the Excel template binary artifact property, if you click the button to the right, you'll see that you can now choose between the different versions stored in the database. Select My Report version 2, and then press OK. Go ahead and commit the changes. Now when we run the report, we'll see version 2, which is based on the Excel template with gray text. But if at any point we want to switch back to version 1, we can simply update the Excel template binary artifact property of the view, commit the changes, and now we're back to version 1 with green text. In this video, we've covered creating a cascade based on our selectors, as well as two ways of updating the Excel template used in our view. In the next video, we'll discuss a few additional properties of the Essbase Excel view, specifically the commonly used properties in the behavior category.